Hi, let's learn about chemisorption, which is one of the types of adsorption. Now we know about adsorption that it is a surface phenomenon in which accumulation of molecular species occurs on the surface of the liquid or solid rather than its bulk. Now what is this new term and how does it occur? So chemisorption or chemical adsorption is a type of adsorption in which the gas molecules and the adsorbent molecules are held together by chemical forces. Now, chemical bonding is really important for this process. Without chemical bonding, it cannot occur. Now let's come to its features. The first one says that it is highly specific in nature. This means that if I have an adsorbent and a gas, then for chemisorption, there must be some possibility of chemical bonding between them for the process to occur. Without this, it cannot happen. That's why it's highly specific. The next one is really common feature that we have been learning since our earlier classes, that chemical processes are irreversible in nature. So is chemisorption. Now, this process is exothermic. At low temperature, the process becomes slow on account of high activation energy. In chemical kinetics, we have learned about the Arrhenius equation, according to which on decreasing the temperature, the activation energy increases and the rate of reaction decreases. That's why at low temperature, the reaction becomes slow. The next is similar to physisorption, chemisorption also increases on increasing the surface area. It is seen that on increasing the temperature, this process increases. The same is seen in the case of high pressure. So high temperature and high pressure are favorable for chemical adsorption. Now, sometimes high activation energy is needed for this process. That's why it is also called activated adsorption. The next is, it has a high value of adsorption enthalpy because of chemical bond formations taking place. It is in the range of 80 to 240 kilojoules per mole. Now, it is really important that it also depends on the gas, on the nature of the gas for this process to occur. Yes, it's a but obvious that it must depend on the gas because everything is going to take place between the adsorbent and the gas. Without their bonding, it cannot happen. So, I have covered almost all the features. It was all about chemisorption. Thank you.